going.
Cool. Clarion. Is this sound that the torches here? Who's this? O? Oh, that was an O in the bar of smoldering flames or whatever the hell, where you find Ignis. There's an O. Hail, Clarion call. Everything's like blurred in here. This young woman wears finely polished armor and paces back and forth restlessly on the walkway. Her long hair is lustrous and healthy, and her whole form exudes a wholesome vitality. When she sees you, she raises her voice in greeting. Welcome, friend, to the Fifth Eye. She strides closer to speak more softly. You come at an exciting time. I have been trying to convince some veteran warriors of their eminent suitability to join the endless battle. So far they have rebuffed me, but perhaps you can succeed where I have failed. Tell me about yourself. I am Clarion. I seek strong warriors, brave souls, to fight in the endless battle, to hold back the advance of the enemy. I recruit warriors for the endless battle. What can you tell me about the endless battle? Much as it sounds. It stemmed from a rift between the changing god and one of his offspring, and has endured for hundreds of years. Raging over the same battlefields, using the deadliest technology of the ancients, the landscape is scarred and pitted beyond recognition. Like the Great War in Planescape Torment. I'm going to keep referencing that, guys. There's a lot of parallels here. The walls between dimensions are thin here, thin there. Everyday horrors cross into our world. She stands, arms akimbo. Worse, in recent years, the struggle has expanded. Nearby settlements, founded to provide material support for the combatants, or existing there long before the two sides came to rage on their borders, have been engulfed by the spreading chaos. She frowns. It's not too late to change the course of the battle. If only warriors of proven mettle would join the fight. That is why I'm here. That is why I beg of your help. She thinks. A glorious conflict. So many have grown stronger in its wake. It's not truly endless, of course, but it has raged for hundreds of years. Imagine the wonders you see around you, the discarded pieces of the ancients' lives. Now imagine all the power bent toward destruction. Imagine what that would do to the land. It is a force, a disaster, that creates heroes. What side are you recruiting for? The changing gods. He has always been a patron of Sega's Cliffs. Perhaps we would not exist if not for his lives and his cast-offs. Certainly we would not be as we are. She pauses. But that is not the only reason. The changing gods' forces are allied with the towns and villages of the Vexulian Waste. We seek to prevent the endless battle from expanding beyond its borders, growing in size once again. The enemy has attempted to sweep across the plain before. They tricked the changing gods' allies, centuries ago, destroyed an army of sand knights, and took half the settlements in the waste. We won't let them do it again. Who is the enemy you're fighting? The armies of the first cast-off. They have never been friends to the people of Sega's Cliffs. She frowns. The first cast-off is long dead, but still her forces hold a grudge against her sire and this patron city. We have allied with the changing towns and villages of the Vexulian Waste. Our forces are trying to stop the enemy from sweeping across the plain. We will contain the endless battle if we can. Can you tell me anything about these veterans you hope to recruit? They have fought in countless battles and emerged victorious. They have made decisive forays that turned entire wars. They are clever and thoughtful. Though I know only their reputation. The third inversion, for instance, saw them reach into a new dimension and... I won't bore you with the details, but they were integral in an offensive that would have changed the course of that conflict. She frowns. They have kept their abilities largely secret from me. I have not seen them in action, but the stories tell of five companions who turn the course of wars. Why are you trying to recruit these veterans? Maybe perhaps they're tired of war. She shakes her head. Conflict shapes us all. It sharpens us, makes us stronger than we ever thought we could be. If you hide from it, you'll never know what you might have become. Or worse, you'll be easy prey for those who are stronger or crueler than you. She clutches your shoulders. These veterans have grown tired and complacent. I want to help them recapture what they lost. No, I want to make them even greater than they were. She thinks, even if they become prey, it will make whomever hunts them very strong. She just wants to make everyone strong. What is there to talk about? Challenge, response, thesis, antithesis, antithesis, synthesis? Overcoming weakness is the only way we grow strong. Do your muscles grow through disuse? Does your mind sharpen while staring at a wall? Life itself is conflict. Without conflict, there is only stasis. Or worse, decay. If I help you, will I get a reward? Of course. I am not a wealthy woman, but I have allies in the city who are. The more veterans you convince to join the battle, the more you will be paid. Fine, then I'll help you recruit the veterans.
I'll remember that.
You will have my gratitude, and a generous reward, if you can succeed in this, friend. She begins to point. At the bar you see Leto, the woman clad in desert robes. Behind the bar, Ferioc. At the table there, Zyobi. She lowers her voice again. With Zyobi you see Theberos. He is older, but he has great experience. She indicates the final target with her chin, and then the crowning piece, Dama. He's their leader. Well, when I asked this question, you didn't tell me their names. Always a pleasure. Aretas, you'll just hang out there, I suppose.
Don't mind if I do.
You're from the wrong game, friend. Your eyes cannot focus on this person. Whether male or female, you cannot say, but it hums with a force that both attracts and repels you. You feel a sense of amusement as its regard settles upon you. You speak with O, it says. You have tasted the truth in the form of machine lubricant. You have contemplated the totality of human existence. Speak quickly and true. The world slows around you. Now, I don't recall exactly what happened, but it was very strange. I think we, we made O vanished or something through dialogue, something like that. The being has no mind to speak of. Same. Yeah, he's from another dimension or something. Where there should be thoughts, you instead sense only a deep, endless hole threatening to swallow your own mind. Who are you? I am O. You might call me an ultra-terrestrial, though I am far more. I am from beyond space, beyond time, above your comprehension. Your mind has chosen this form for me, and I am content to exist in this structure. But know that I exist also outside of your subjective experience. Some might describe me as a superpositional extraction of fundamental universal laws made tangible. It gestures languidly, and you understand perfectly. I am a word made flesh. A letter, at least. A concept, covered in a false skin, infinitely malleable, essentially unknowable. What does it mean to be a word? I was, am, will be. I see into the infinite past, into the illimitable future. When the cosmos erupted into a sea of light, I saw it. When the mechanism winds to a sad and creeping end, I will weep. At the moment the great wings of death enclose creation, I am the last vestige of dust, frozen, forever perfected. Was I always? Was I created? My origin is hidden from me, but I see. I act only in accordance with my nature. I simply am. What are you doing here? I am here to see the final attempt at entry by the adversaries. I am here to offer a vision to Leto. Did Did you say this was the final attempt at entry by the adversaries? The adversaries sought to peel through realities, to devour this world, as they have others. They have never lost. This world is their first taste of defeat. Within themselves, the eaten cores of their victims begin to stir. The adversaries will cease to exist in any meaningful form within a millennium if they are stopped here. This is an inflection point. If the warriors here succeed, the adversaries do not rise again for an eon. It is written. You said you had come to offer a vision to Leto. She is prescient. She is the mother of empires. The adversary's presence has polluted her vision, and she has strayed from the page. I am here to reunite her with the truth. I do not intervene, but this story was true, and so it is true, and so this is not an intervention. The vision will come when you have left the city. She will see you she will see clearly when you leave the city. You will have no further part in her story. Where did you come from? You would not understand. Let me show you. Its eyes widen, expanding to fill the room, your vision, your consciousness, and you tumble into a starry immensity. Swirls of nebula twist and knot, and in the hearts of these stellar clusters roar hungry vortices. You tumble helplessly into a myriad of them at once, torn apart and reformed in an instant, a being of pure light and will. You find yourself standing in the fifth eye again. Your nose is running, and tears streak your cheeks. You wipe them away numbly, and you realize your hand is streaked with blood. So we took one damage to health pool. We permanently gained one intellect. Nice. Maximum intellect pool is now 11. Yay! Worth it? Oh my god, we are 666 with our abilities here. Too much information. Too much knowledge. Had I shown you more, the energies that bind you together would have failed. What if I... You have seen once. To see again would be to unmake you. Okay. I have come to watch, to taste, to be, to help you end your fluttering between possibilities. Well, thanks for that. Farewell, but he says, a moment. None here will know of our conversation. None will know its nature. None see me, nor will they recognize any sign of me. Even in this unremarkable place, they cannot know. But I give you a gift, cast off, and God, and woman, for yours is a true story. It is welcomed into the world. It was born from desire, and will end in... But no, I do not tell you your fortune. Whoa. Light envelops you. When you open your eyes, O is gone. So we permanently gained 4 health pool. Maximum is now 25. Sweet. That was worth it. Continue. Live. Breathe. Well, thanks for that. Oh, he's always yellow. Let's talk to, Yusig. The Smoldering Corpse Bar. That was the name of it. That's where the other O was in Planescape Torment. The most distinguishing feature of this tall, vaguely awkward man is the yellow shirt he wears. He seems desperate to fade back into the scenery. When he sees you notice him, he gives a faint, uncomfortable grin. Something about him seems off, as if he were a flicker in the air, or strangely two-dimensional. He does not seem to emit a sense of presence at all. Like O. Who are you? Aaron, called Sig. He almost whispers. I am not here. No, this is like a dream to me. Can you tell me anything about the people here? He shakes his head, as if terrified to meet your gaze. Let's try again. Ditto. What can you tell me about this place? Nothing. His eyes are haunted, as if he were desperate to be away from this conversation. No. Why can't I sense you? Skist, he mutters. Whoa. Ooh, hello. You've lost your skin. The The yellow shirt fades away, and then the skin, muscle, and bone. What remains is a vaguely humanoid shimmer. I am Sig. I don't know how to say that. Erin, a transdimensional projection from a distant past. This abacos form. This is not the truth of me, trapped in this body. But I am not this. What's an abacos? A ghost. Transdimensional. It feeds. I only watch. Watch and learn. It is a feeder. A hunter. Not of this world. Not of this time. Where are you from? Distant past. Epochs ago. Tuning through time. To see future. Overshot. It shrugs vaguely. Maybe next visit. Distant time. Unsure. Can you affect this reality? Only words. The ghostly hands pass through you. Nothing touches. Only ideas. No physical energy conveyed. Does this have anything to do with the whatever? The lady who's lost her identity. How did you get to this place in particular? When casting through time, saw light, drawn to civilized thought, admiring physics. That's it. Farewell. Interesting.
It is done.
Almas the Soul Keeper, hail! Do not keep my soul. For a moment, you are not entirely sure as if you look upon a construct or a human. The plastic sheen of this pale man's skin suggests artificiality. But if he is a construct, he is so cunningly constructed, so close to the human baseline, that the illusion is nearly perfect. Except his head is a trifle too large, his eyes black buttons. Then you realize the truth. He is a visitant, his home many millions of miles distant. Almas, my name. What can you tell me of yourself? There's a lot of strange beings in here. He lifts his great head slowly and fixes you with a dolorous gaze. I am Almas. I am the keeper of souls. Last of my kind, only survivor of a civilization that spanned time and space. Now they are gone, their stars black. Reality's winds carry me. He turns his head back toward his drink. Keeper of my people, dreamer of the dead, a visitant, a wanderer. What happened to your people? The highest caste of power, controlled we minds, ideas, for all souls of empire. A great web we wove, shining with power, but other nodes, they winked away, until only I remained. His fingers drum on the tabletop. An image of my people I carry, but no place to make it real. Our domain lost. I alone and paralyzed with indecision and fear. He thinks, did I destroy them? I was not discontented. Or was I? Strong we were. We dominated our place. We made justice. Yet strength was not enough to prevent rot from within. How did your civilization die? A doubt arose. It took seed. Took flight. Like a githzerai. These thoughts connected to our network. These questions spread like disease. Trust. Mistrust rooted. Nodes decored? Without nodes, without control of our dreams, the civilization falls, and then they are gone. I alone remain. You have to have strong will and belief to live as a githzerai, and yeah, if you have doubt in your people, that's pretty interesting. Through doubt, questions spread through great mental network, failure of belief. Failure to thrive. What was the doubt that destroyed your civilization? I do not know. I do not recall. Yet something in his stance suggests otherwise. And he thinks, I know. I recall. How can you not remember the destruction of your civilization? It was sudden. I watched it decohere. The stars winking back. I witnessed. a voyeur to utter destruction. I found its beauty before I knew, marveled at its artistry. I saw more, felt less, and then it was gone. I questioned the early blackness. I saw it, and I did nothing. It was an emptiness, a sadness. I denied its presence. When it spread, I watched. I did not know. It was a moment of terror, a cascade of uncertainty. Who knows what is true, what is memory of fear? Tell me the doubt that destroyed your civilization. I know you know. I do. Yes, it was my doubt. Mine. My question. I asked only, what if our way is not best? What if our people have desires of their own, wants that we do not give? He places a single hand across his eyes, and then slowly slides it away. The others began to see, and question. Questions gave way to self-doubt. Self-doubt gave way to self-hate. I wanted only to know, what is best? How do we become better? Not to tear us down. But I shone a bright light on behavior, on truth. But our center could not hold under truth. His wet, terrified eyes fix on yours. Was I to blame? Is civilization's end affixed on me? In dreams I see their faces, but not their minds. Tell me truly, is the fault mine? I can't do that. Are you sure they're gone? What if they saw your doubt and just cut you away, cast you aside? Blue and indigo. Horror dawns on his face. Is that why I cannot feel them? Why I retain only an image? He closes his eyes and concentrates, hard. Around the bar, other patrons wince and cover their ears with their hands. You feel the brushing of a great and terrifying howl of anguish. Damn. He whispers, I am alone. I feel an echo, but no true response, as if they hide. He pulls his hands apart, and you have the sense of a vast network of power contained between them. He raises his hands before his face, and then he crumples his fist. The energy vanishes. I have severed the last connection, the last hope. If they exist still, they must exist without me. Let me be forgotten. No more, he whispers. No more. He drops his head and weeps. Aww. Please. I must be alone. That's unfortunate. Oh, ghostly woman. Hey, ghostly woman! Spend some ghostly time with me. You draw closer, but the wispy form of the woman in the booth does not clarify. You can hardly discern the details of her ghostly face, and you hear a chorus of whispering female voices that swarm around her like chance moths. Chance moths. She has to do with the lady upstairs. Listen to the whispers. They brush against your mind just below the level of conscious thought. You hear them, but not with your ears. You can only make out snatches of the whispers in your mind. You killed me, created me, never wanted to die. Unmade me, only wanted peace. Your fault I live. Study her face more carefully. You peer more closely at her, and she takes no notice of you. Her features are those of a teenage woman, leaving childhood behind. It's an odd pair, teenage woman. I guess 18, 19. You have seen her face before, somewhere in this city. The ghostly woman could be her twin. Hello? She has been ignoring you, but, without a transitional state, her face is suddenly and furiously focused on yours. Another flicker and her hands wrap around your throat. Ghost or not, her fingers are very real, and they are choking the life from you. Let the ghost strength... No. I mean, technically, we can. Oh, crap, we lost. Failure. Her fingers dig deeper. She's not just compressing your trachea. She's tearing your throat out. You choke and cough, drowning on your blood, but she is latched inside you, and the last thing you see is her rage-twisted face.
I'm hurt.
Yeah, it hurts. Oh my. Oh, there she is. The air is warm next to this machine, and you feel dizzy whenever you go near it. Well, it's a good thing we're not near it. Oh, wow. So, where are we? Ghostly Fathom? Daughter's Fathom. Now, whose daughter? Hail. It's the same ghostly woman who strangled you, but the fury is gone from her face, replaced with confusion. She looks around. Her gaze falls on the large machine and lingers there. Finally, she notices you. She steps forward, a hint of trepidation in her eyes. Where are we? Do you know? She thinks, how do I know that machine? It frightens me, and I don't know why. You killed me! Silvertide. She cocks her head quizzically. But you're not dead, and I don't remember killing you. Are you certain it was me? She looks around her and sighs. Then again, there is a lot I do not recall. I do remember one thing. She puts her hands to the sides of her head. I was angry, enraged. There are... She turns on you. I don't know how, but there are women like me born throughout the city, repeatedly, against their will. She thinks, my memories are flitting back to me like flies. What drove them away? Still wondering if this has anything to do with the lady who... lost herself, and she has that... I can't remember. Loss of self, exactly. Lost herself. If she has anything to do with loss of self... What do you mean? They are compelled into existence. She bites her lip, uncertain. Then she nods. I'm just a memory, but something is forcing my memory into the minds of women throughout the city.
Making a note.
She takes your hand in hers. It's wrong. I don't know how I know, but... She looks away, lost in her own thoughts. When she turns back to you, there is more certainty in her voice. Find them. The women becoming like me, or already like me. Maybe I'll remember more. Maybe we can do something. Look! You follow her finger to a glowing form where before there was nothing. It's a membra. You found one of them already. The women created by the engine. I did? Is that something to be afraid of? Oh, loss of self. She's a membra? Have you found any more of the women? We have to help them. How do I find these women? They are in the real world, in Sagas. You may have even met them without realizing it. I only have vague impressions of them. I know that one of them is a leader. She has sacrificed much of her life, and so gained life in return. A leader. Could be the head of the head of the guard. In the government square, or could be the one running that time portal thing. She shakes her head as though to clear it. I'm sorry, I can't tell you more than that. One of them offers joy and sorrow for coin. Her family is not her own. It's borrowed, I think. Oh my god. The girl with the flute. She shakes her head as though to clear it. I'm sorry, I can't tell you more than that. Don't forget, we must know more.
Yes.
Okay. This thing, I feel scared when I go near it.
On it.
On it. Oh, that's the portal back. To the calm.
Of course.
But of course. Alright, let's talk to, loss of self. What the hell? What the hell's going on here? Go ghostly woman says, "The siege," she says, watching the scene in front of you. "I remember the siege when the Tabat came to destroy Sega's cliffs." Do you remember it? I think it happened a long time ago. Did it? I'm only a broken memory, apparently. What do I know of time? A wry smile plays on her lips. After a long, quiet moment, she nods as though coming to a decision. That's very distracting over there. "I was there. I remember the screams, the terror. The Tabat came. Many of them mounted on their dragoliths, each of them with a stranger, more terrifying weapon than the one before. Sega should have fallen, like Shuenta and Ika and 100 villages before us, but it didn't. We fought them off." She thinks, "It's coming back to me. These are my memories." She shakes her head. "But what does that have to do with the other women? I don't know. There's more to this story. I need your help to find it." Well, that's her. That's me. "Can you tell me about the siege again?" "Tabat were everywhere. So many people died. I remember their screams. It's a miracle Sega's cliff survived. One of them is dead, and yet a piece of her lives. Find that piece." Okay, I definitely know who one of them is. "Don't forget, we must know more." We can't actually speak to them. Interesting. "This burning building looks like homes you've seen in Sega's cliffs, but of a much older style."
Go.
They don't speak. "This is all just a memory, but the heat from the rubble, as well as the smell of burning wood and flesh, feels very real. This is awesome. Blood-curdling moans can be heard from inside the structure, but there's no way in." Well, I don't mean this whole thing, people dying and burning alive, is awesome. It's just this whole scene is awesome.
Let's go.
Oh, I can't advance any further.
I'm going.
So what happened to, what's her name? What happens to loss of self? What happened to loss of self?
Yes.
I love this with the boards, like, floating around and stuff. It's cool. Okay.
I'm going.
Into the calm we go. Spectre, am I glad you came out of that door? The thing just showed up. I didn't know what to expect. Do you know who the ghostly woman is in that fathom? He shakes his head. Don't know anything about that one. That way is blocked. He shrugs. It's not surprising, really. It's your mind, not mine. Most likely she's just a lacuna, a construct of your buried memories. Either that or she's a reflection of someone you met in real life. Whoever or whatever she is, she probably isn't real. You're the only one with that distinction. He chuckles to himself. And me, by extension. Has anything changed since the last time I was here? He shrugs. Look around. It's your mind. Answer my question. What should I do now? You need to find this Metkina person. She might not know how to fix the chamber, but she's the only lead we have on who can. This Metkina is our best lead. Good luck. That's the daughter's fathom. That's to the ninth world.
Yes, now.
Hopefully not attacked by the sorrow thing.
Yes, now.
Yes, now, baby. So do we go back where we came from, or do we have to work our way back?